We've got Lance listening in Atlantic City to WPG. Hello, Lance.
Hey, good evening. First and foremost, my condolences to everyone involved, the family of the young man, Mr. Brown, that unfortunately made poor decisions while he was in the store, and also for the officer in charge that unfortunately made a impromptu decision to whatever he did. But this is still under investigation. Bottom line is, I hate to say it, but the media, not you, not your radio station, but the visual media mm-hmm. that puts news out and social media, tweets, YouTube, everything that anybody has a cell phone. I'm surprised that no one there had a cell phone until after the episode went down.
Well, you're talking about the shooting of you're talking about the shooting of Michael Brown in Ferguson.
Absolutely.
Okay, so I'm a journalist, and I have a cell phone that has a camera on it, and I can actually stream live to the internet. But it takes me sometimes as long as 30-45 seconds to get going.
Seconds? Absolutely. And you don't know the spontaneity. See, that's the thing that that a lot of people don't understand. Law enforcement officers, when they go through the training program, they are taught to use deadly force, shoot to kill. Now, I don't know.
They're supposed
exactly
to be, hold on, they're supposed to be taught to only, you know, to try to de-escalate encounters. They're supposed to be taught to only use the appropriate amount of force in response to what is being used against them in order to be able to
What's
subdue
your first name?
The individual.
What's your first name?
I'm Ian, and Mark's on the other side of the table here.
Ian, mm-hmm. Mark. Regardless of what job we take and what training we get, we're supposed to be gifted and endowed with common sense. And as long as I can remember, my fifth or sixth year that I was growing up, if a police officer or a person in authority, in a uniform, said to me, stop, halt, I stopped, I halted, and I didn't move. And that's common sense. See, no one.
I don't think that's common sense. That. See, the fact is when you're talking about different groups deal with law enforcement differently. If, for instance,
Absolutely.
Now let's look at the history of police in the United States. The fact is, you can look at the lineage from slave grabbers. You know, the people that went out and captured slaves and returned them to their masters, and how
you
those people moved.
Yeah,
they moved directly into law enforcement. Same individuals. Police didn't even exist until the 1850s. Those people transitioned over, and oftentimes law enforcement has been used as an agency to control, people of color. I wouldn't doubt for a second that there are people of color in this nation that when a police officer says to halt, they run.
Ian, please don't say people of color.
All right.
Because back in the 1850s, there was still a class set up society.
You
either an indentured servant, or you were evolving out of being in slavery.
Indentured servitude didn't exist in the 1850s.
It wasn't.
Brother, you're still in slavery. I hate to break this to you, but
I have news for you. People enslave themselves, Ian, and you know that. Come on.
I'm not sure what you mean by that.
You mean to like banks?
They make decisions that shorten their opportunities to make rational decisions, and they do it either out of insecurities, peer pressure, or cultural values.
There's certainly no doubt that people can choose.
I'm not a sociologist. I'm
Great.
Not into
Me neither.
The ethnic
But we can both talk about these things. Now, Lance,
Absolutely.
Thank you for the call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Sure, people can choose to enslave themselves to addiction. They can choose to enslave themselves to some sort of contract.
Here's what I don't understand. Why in the world are people defending a public servant, you know, your employee that was supposed to be here to protect you, that shot another civilian just like you in the back who was unarmed? At this point, there's no defense for that.
Mark, he stole a box of cigars.
He may or may not have stolen a box of cigars. He may or may not have punch somebody, but that's not a reason to draw your weapon and use deadly force.
Absolutely.
This was a neighborhood. Do you know how, I mean, when police officers shoot, they often miss 2 out of 3 times.
Yep.
You're lucky this bullet didn't go somewhere and kill someone else too.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.